Saker grass shear and hedger. Saker sent me this grass shear and edger in exchange for an honest review and use video. This tool is intended for cutting and trimming thin shoots on hedges, bushes, and ornamental shrubs, as well as cutting small sections of lawn. The motor output is 20 volts DC with an 8-inch hedge trimmer blade length and maximum diameter of 1/4 inch. The battery pack voltage is 20 volts 1.5 amp hours. Follow all safety warnings, instructions, illustrations and specifications provided with the power tool. Safety is your responsibility. To pivot the cutting head, press the button in and move the body on tool in the direction you want it to angle. To swap the cutting blade sections, press in on the two buttons and pull the blade away from the blade body. To install the blade, line up blade with blade body and press on. To install the battery, press the button on battery and slide onto the grooves of the handle. To power the tool, slide thumb button forward and squeeze the finger trigger.
Okay, so I showed you how the grass trimmer worked, and it's really handy around our pool and our jacuzzi because a string trimmer, you could poke a hole in it. So as long as you're careful with this, it works really good for around trimming around the pools and stuff like that in your garden. Did really good. Now, whenever you change these blades out, I suggest popping the battery out. Remember, providing safety is up to you. Gloves and eyeglasses, safety glasses would be recommended. To take this off, you just squeeze in on these two buttons and kind of rock it back and forth, just like so. And you'll take your, we're going to try the hedge trimmer. Now, I haven't charged this battery. It's actually still going on what it came with as far as charge, because I didn't plan on doing a whole lot with it because the video would be way too long. But you got this nice bar here, and I just trimmed my hedges, but I have some cane that grows on the back fence that's in a, actually the railroad owns the land behind the fence. And I just try to kind of keep it cut even with the top of the fence. And I got a little bit I can try to cut with this, but it's not too big. So let's give that a try and see what happens. I'm going to go ahead and slide this battery back in. And we'll go over there and I'll set you up so you can watch that. So you can see the cane that's growing back here. And this is my fence. I try to keep it level. Now I've got, there's some barbed wire back here. It was there when I bought the house, so I'm carefully just going to try to see if it'll cut some of this cane. Good quarter inch there. It'll fit in this gap, you'll cut it. Thank you. be careful because there is barbed wire off in here, and I don't want to get that in this saw. But it does trim it up. Hey, that does look much better. Some of it's too big for it to get in between its teeth. Guys, I think I proved it. It'll cut. It's really for shrubs, and cane's kind of tough to cut in some thicknesses. But yeah, I just trimmed my shrubs the other day, so I will get a video when they grow back out, trimming them up with this Saker trimmer.
See links in the description for this product. Pick yours up and get one to give as a gift. The Saker Grass and Hedge Trimmer has Outdoors for Adventure's seal of approval for those light-duty, quick-trim jobs.